what I will do next week, you'll see. Okay, so that's putting the model back together. I haven't totally put it back together as yet. I've just quickly mocked it up here with the wheels. Hi and welcome to CS Diecast Tune In. I hope you guys are all well. Today, as you can see, I've totally done the spraying. Previous video would have been taking the paint off and prepping it to be resprayed. This is the finished model. As you can see, it's in Olympic blue. I've had it a couple of weeks now as it is. I haven't actually done anything to it, but it looks really good. The bonnet's there, you've got the boot, your two doors, and I also sprayed the underside. I've masked the drive shaft and the sump, so that didn't get any spray paint on it. So as you can see here, I'm just gonna quickly show you there. So I masked that off. So today I'll quickly run down the process of getting to this stage, because I didn't actually film this stage, is when you put the base paint or the primer on, is to spray the gloss coat soon after, maybe 10 minutes after you've put the primer on. You still want that primer to be tacky, and not, you don't want that primer or base coat to be hardened. So you want those gloss paint to bond in with the primer. That's the main thing you want to do. You want the gloss paint bonding with the primer, so don't let the primer dry or harden. So when it's a little bit tacky, you then put your next coat on, and till you're satisfied with the coverage on that model, you then go straight in doing the gloss. And obviously, depending on what type of paint you use, if you're using a two-pack paint, you won't even need to put a lacquer on. It'll absolutely look superb, which this is a two-pack paint that I'm using on there. What method you use, that's entirely up to you, but this is how I normally do my models and how I get my finishes. So it's important to start off with a good surface, hence why I always clean the models down and give them a wet and dry, just to make sure that surface is absolutely smooth in order to put the primer on, and then obviously the gloss coat. If you want a real sheen, and you can lacquer it, just protect the paint itself, but 9 times out of 10 you don't need to. So that's basically it. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to try and put as much of the model back together. So that means putting the doors back on, bonnet, boots, etc., and maybe putting the glass back in. I'm not 100% certain. I'll see how far I get today, and then obviously next week we'll be putting in the details. Like in the engine bay, there's obviously, I've got to paint in sort of cables, struts, and any ancillaries that needs painting in. And obviously with these models, escort models, you need to sort of paint in the rubbers around the windows. I mean, most people don't bother with that, but it does add to the detail, and it makes the car look more authentic when you paint in the rubbers black and do those little details. Those are the nice touches, so I will be doing that. Obviously door handles, fog lights, what else I've got to do with this, and the wheels. These are actually, the actual rims are fine, but the tyres are low profile. I need to actually fit some fatter tyres on there, but they will look good. I've also got an aluminium exhaust box, rear box, to go on there. There's a couple of seats here. I'm not sure if I will use them with headrests. It's one of those things that I think I'm going to sort of decide upon when I'm putting this car back together, have a little bit of thinking time. So I'm going to do this in quick time, so otherwise it takes forever. So here we go. Okay, so that's putting the model back together. I haven't totally put it back together as yet. I've just quickly mocked it up here with the wheels. As you can see, it's got the mini light wheels on. I am going to change the tyres. It needs to be higher tyres, not such a low profile tyre as what I've got on these. So hopefully I can get the correct size tyres to go on here. Few bits to go in will be the radiator, dashboard, the windscreen. But so I'm not going to be able to do that today. What I will do next week, you'll see, I will be doing in the rubbers on the windscreen. I've also got to drill a hole to fit door mirror on the left hand side, because this only had a right hand side door mirror. I've got to drill a hole to fit another mirror on both sides. So that's what I'm going to also do next week, and sort out the bumpers, cut bumpers, and sort out some fog lights. They're either fog lights or driving lights for the front end. So there's not too much. It's going to be the detailing and the final touches, which will take a bit of time to do, and it takes a bit of patience. Doing the rubbers for the windscreen, masking, that's, you know, it's time consuming doing masking and trying to curve it around the edges and then spraying it. You can either spray it or you can actually hand paint it in. If you're good enough, you can hand paint it in and then remove the masking tape. It's entirely up to you which course of action you take. So yes, that's what I'm going to do, just because I never have enough time to do anything. I've run out of time, and I need to sort out orders that I've got to ship out this week. So yeah, so that's what I'm going to do now. So I'm going to have to leave the model, but it does, you can see it does look really good. I think it's going to be still very basic. I am changing the seats. I think they're the Escort gear seats. They got the little headrests at the back. I'm just going to spray that in a matte black, fit those in. The wheels are going to be the next. I'm going to have to do a video on how to change the wheels, because obviously it's never that straightforward, but I will explain how to get these wheels off and replace them with these. It's going to make a heck of a difference. Okay, till next week. Thanks for watching, and do give it a good old thumbs up, and please subscribe. See ya.